everybody. How's it hanging? How's it happening? You guys know this is Kevin from the Chord Progression Podcast, the podcast Rolling Stone Magazine says initiates profound discussions with rock and metal artists, allowing fans to discover the creative workflow of their favorite musicians and understand the factors that make the band succeed or fall from fame. We are also sponsored by Dark Fusion Systems, the best of your custom computing needs. Get $100 off your entire business code CPPOD at darkfusionsystems.com. Link to the podcast below. Now let's go to our feature presentation. If you guys like bands like Bad Omens, Deftones, Fearbox, and Loathe, you want to get emotional and swing heavy in the pit, this band's for you. We have Gore on the podcast with members Alex and Devin. We ask them about their history. We show you why they make the music they do that's going to be emotional and heavy hitting all at the same time, and get you hyped up to check them out with the release of their brand new debut EP, A Bud That Never Blooms, coming out on October 24th via Spine Farm Records. Get ready. Get the tissues out. This is a good one. You guys ready? Let's go! Yeah. Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, listeners of the Chord Progression Podcast. This band was sent to me by none other than Miss Tori Kravitz from She's With The Band, saying, hey, go check these guys out, see what's up, see if you want to talk to them. And after seeing their four fans of being Bad Omens, Deftones, Spiritbox, and Loathe, with a sound characterized by a sludgy, heavy metal instrumentation juxtaposed with ethereal melodies and fierce roars, I'm like, okay, you gotta go and check this out. After checking, I'm like, I gotta bring this band to the podcast. And with a brand new EP, the debut EP called A Bud That Never Blooms, coming out on October 24th via another than Spine Farm Records, and supporting with In the Ruins on a little run in October 2024, why not go check them out now and get to know them now before everyone else does? So please welcome Alex and Devin from the band Gore to the podcast. So gentlemen, welcome to Chord Progression Podcast.
What's up, guys?
How's it going, guys?
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, I appreciate
it. It is a pleasure having you guys. How is everything going in your world today as we start this good old conversation out as well in the time of the day right now? We're getting towards the evening hours. So how you guys doing today?
Not too bad, you know, dealing with some rain down here in Houston. But I got to say, not too bad, not too shabby.
Yeah, going pretty good here. Just packing, getting ready to head to Alex tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm going to see that beautiful dome.
The nice chrome dome.
That beautiful chrome dome to get some jamming in, to get some good times in, and who knows what else will come up of that, because it's probably going to be ridiculous. It's probably going to be crazy. And, well, if you're in the Texas area and you see them out and about doing some silly stuff, join in on the fun.
Yeah, man.
Or just say or just don't ask questions. Just
yeah.
Leave us be.
Just leave them be. Just, you know, we see them. It's like, treat them like, you know, wildlife. It's gaze upon them, but do not approach them.
You're just going to see us like
wild animals.
Do not make a move.
And then they make a move and you guys just scurry off into the distance.
That's actually how we operate, to be honest with you.
Scurry off in the distance and frolic through the tall grass together while making incredibly good music. I mean, not bad.
I mean, you know, to each his own.
Yeah, to each his own. Well, I want to make sure we can get as many people as possible to know about Gore, to get to know about your band and get to know everything you guys are. And one way I like to do that is I saw you, you know, from the history of the band, debuted in 2023, and with a brand new EP coming out, the debut EP, I couldn't really find much on the history of the band. So I want to hear the history directly from the source, directly from you guys. What's the history of Gore and how did this all come to be? But I don't want just some, you know, well, this is a U.S. history style presentation, pull out a PowerPoint. No. What I want is something that's going to be epic, incredible, and going to make us say we want more. So basically, this has to be like the original Iron Man. So I'll let you guys take it away.
That's quite the buildup, man. It's hard to top. I'm getting sweat. I need some water, man. Hey, yeah. Devin, you want to take this on?
Oh man! All right. Let's see. So Haley was the one who started the band. She let's see. So she had the vision. It started with her vision for the band. She wanted to make something that was, I don't know, kind of felt like a little larger than life. She wanted to bring in heaviness, but she also wanted to bring in, like, you know, angelic vocals, kind of meshing those two worlds. Because she had a large, like, death metal background and whatnot. But she's like, I want to sing. I want to, you know, make people cry. Like, riffs and sad, you know? And so that's kind of how that formed. And so we start, and Haley and I, how we got connected, because some people might be like, well, they're in Texas, you're in Michigan. It doesn't make sense. But Haley and I have actually been friends for like, coming up on 10 years or something like that. I think it was just like Jen, posting groups, something like that. So we've been friends for a while. We both had similar like engineering backgrounds. So we kind of clicked that way. And I saw her like put out a little feeler like, hey, I got some demos around. Like, I'm looking for people interested in joining. And I was like, I'm all about it. Let's do it. How about you, Alex?
Yeah, so piggybacking on what Devin just said, yeah, like basically she had a vision and we were all for it whenever we joined the group. And the way I thought about it is like we want you to be in the pit, but we also want you to cry while you're in the pit. You know? Just like, I hate you, Dad. Why? But yeah, so like Haley is the brains of when it comes to the vision, and we have all kind of like picked in into like ideas and what we think. It's a very democratic way that we run the band. And the way I kind of got, introduced to Haley was, honestly, I met her when her own original band, her very first band in Houston. And through acquaintances, and then we just like our friendship grew from there. And it was been a few years already. And then she put out a feeler saying, "Hey, also looking for musicians to come in and join a group." And I was like, "Dude, sign me in." I saw her. I've seen her with her original death metal band, and she just is a monster on stage, and she's just very talented. And dude, I was like, I want to be in that group. I can only imagine. And that, the rest, as they say, is history. Now we're here.
The rest, as they say, is history. To music being made for you to cry in the pit and just go full on, just like, I'm so sad. Why didn't you make me?
That is the goal. Honestly, I mean, if we can say that we did that, our fans feel that, die
Yep.
happy now.
Yep. Depression and spin kicks. That's what we're all about.
Pointless karate kicks.
The feel of Bass Seeker, the crowd intensity of a Loathe show all rolled into one, baby. Yep.
Honestly, that's right. That's
That's
so
like the
spot
formula right
on.
there.
Yeah, that's so spot on.
Honestly, if you guys come up with something like put that in a press release, literally, you might just see some people be like, wait, how did those two go together? But then you start thinking like, oh, who's Dayseeker going out with in October of like 2024? Oh, their direct support is Alpha Wolf. Yeah, so everybody's kicking each other's ass in the pit, then they're gonna go to crying in the pit. You guys just found a way to, how do we make that happen all at the same time?
Do it in one set.
Shoot, we're doing it in one song, bro.
Yeah, pretty much.
One song, you're doing it one song every song.
Yeah,
Yeah.
pretty much.
But of course, we can jump into the songs in a little bit, but just taking a listen to, the origin story, how you guys got connected. Of course, when it comes to Haley just being as up like out there when it comes to starting her own death metal band beforehand and trying her best to, make this in the music scene. As you said, Devin, you and her and are was it engineers or
Yeah, both engineers.
yeah, both engineers. So it's like, okay, you've got a vision, you've got a dream, you've got a goal, and you've got a passion to do something that might be outside of, your day job, which a lot of us have. So go and maximize on it, go and try it. And then you never know where you're going to find other people that are going to potentially help you out with your vision or join in on your vision to really grow it. You never know where you're going to find them, but if you don't try and you don't put it out there, you're never going to get to that point because you never know what might happen. You're going to find someone like Alex, who's, you've been pl seeing her play for a number of years, had played potentially with her alongside on some shows for a number of years, but through that connection, that acquaintance, and then that she's trying something and you're down for it, let's see where that goes. Or Devin, literally, when you said it was like on some gent shitposting group that you met her on, I'm like, you know what? You never know where you're gonna find some absolute beautiful people. You never know where you're gonna find some people that are gonna absolutely connect with you and maybe go along with your vision and really support it. You might find them on Reddit. You might find them on a gent shit posting group and have a shit ton of fun with it. But at the same time, it all depends upon how we make those connections with people. And when we try and put good on the world, you know, good's going to end up coming back. And it seems like that's what happened here, especially from Haley's side and then from both of your guys as well, to really create this thing that is Gore and have been working on it with a brand new EP coming out. So, yeah, I guess it's pretty damn good.
I'd say so. I mean,
yeah, going pretty swell.
Pretty swell.
Got to get that meme like, hey, that's pretty good. Like right after.
Cool beans.
Cool beans.
Cool beans, bro. But it's still insane just to think that, you know, that how that's all it all came together. And then the sound being characterized, you know, again, you're going to feel like Dayseeker, but you're going to spin kick like you're at a Lowe's show. When it came to really not only creating the sound, I know if that was Haley's, you know, more vision around that, I totally understand. But when it comes to creating that sound, especially creating the music and really maximizing on that, because as members of the band, you're also tasked with amplifying all that as well and helping create that. How do you guys really help do that to make sure that Gore is as best it possibly can be?
Well, yeah, it's kind of – go for it, Devin.
Oh, yeah. I say, like, from the bass side of things, like, I'm actually like, I'm a converted guitarist. So like, this is actually kind of a different role for me. Like, I'm a huge death metal guy. I love just like nuts riffs. That's my bread and butter. But this was kind of different. Like, I always wanted to pick up bass for something, and I've been like staring at a ding wall forever. And this was kind of like the perfect opportunity. She needed a bassist, and I was like, let's do it. So like, it's kind of a different role for me versus stuff I've worked on in the past, where like, my only goal in this band is just to make it sound just huge, you know?
Want to feel it in my stomach.
Yeah. Those 20 hertz bass lines. You know? Yeah. How about you, Alex?
It's like, I want to feel it so deep in my stomach where it's like I'm questioning if it's growling because it's hungry or it's just reacting to the bass riff in a physical way. Like,
oh, yeah.
Only one or the other. Yeah. And if I just got done eating, I know which one it is.
Oh, yeah. Like, come out to a show. We're hitting the brown note.
I'm still questioning it.
Yeah.
Yeah, as far as like the guitar stuff, like I'm a technique guy. I love learning new techniques, and I'm not very well versed in like theory, but I do have like a basic knowledge of it. And to me, being in Gore and learning Gore stuff and adding to Gore, it's like we got the rule book, just throw it out of here. Like, we don't need that. We need emotion. And that's pretty much like where that heaviness comes from. It's just like, it's just raw emotion. And then we kind of just, on the guitar side, that's what I try to like help out with it being a like a full circle type of thing, especially with tones. Like, me and Devin, like the last time that I was in Michigan, me and Devin were just like nerding out on just gear and just like tones. And he was like showing me like the Gojira plugin on Neural, and I was just like, oh my god, this is so freaking awesome. Like, so like, we have like our moments. So yeah.
One thing that I kind of find interesting about just that whole entire piece, especially Alex, when you brought up overall music theory, and you just take the music theory book and kick it out the window. Of course, even for myself, I'm not a musician, but of course I've been, you know, interviewing musicians, really focusing on this for over 5.5 years at this point. So I kind of got some of that knowledge in there. And when it comes to music theory, yes, I see it as a great tool to understand certain aspects, especially when you're stuck on something, because it'll help give you a guide. It'll help, you know, help you figure out exactly where to go from one progression next, one emotion to the next, and how is that going to max out and sound the most cohesive. However, though, I'm really not the fan of sticking to theory completely, or really just as a rule, because if you stick to theory completely, it limits creativity to within the bounds of what music theory is saying and what music theory is telling you. When bands and artists have kicked that idea to the curb and have tried some crazy, wacky, ridiculous things, yes, theory can help, but when you try some crazy out of the box, doesn't make any sense on paper, doesn't make any sense, you know, when you speak it out, but in your brain it might happen. And then when you put it out into the world and you really try and make it, it absolutely works. Those are the artists that tend to, especially in today's day and age, really stand out and overall succeed beyond belief. I mean, a big proponent of that, and I think a big example of that, look at Bring Me the Horizon, all the different changes they made, and especially getting crazier and crazier as time goes on, It fits. Sleep Token, there's some things they threw out, Theory, and it hits. Bad Omens, Falling in Reverse. You could go on and on. And a lot of these artists that are just trying these crazy things that don't seem like they make any sense, and then you listen when they absolutely do make sense, that's when that absolute creativity really flows and you find something brand new. And that's what it seems like you guys are doing too, where of course you have the idea behind it, but if you throw the rule book out, then you can add some of those incredibly heavy parts that, like you said, Devin, you know, when you're, you know, from a converted guitarist playing some of those heavy riffs and those death metal riffs, you're going to have a consistent flow to them, but then you can have some more of these elegant melodies and elegant pieces that add into it out of nowhere that really change up the sound at certain points in time to really make you get that emotional feel. Or you get that sludgy riff in there from Alex and all of a sudden now it gets really clean while he's still having that 20 megahertz bass line. Stomach, it can all fit together. And even if Theory doesn't say it, it fits together. Try it out, record it, practice it. I don't care what it is, but you might find either that it works, it doesn't work. But even if it doesn't work, you might get inspired to find what is going to work, and that to not only make the song as cohesive as you want it to be, but also hit on every single emotional piece that you are going for.
Yeah, absolutely. I totally agree. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because we actually have like people in our corner, like our team is, especially the producers that we worked with, it's a perfect match of energies, and when it comes to like the recording and like the songwriting aspect of things. And yeah, like you said, Theory gets you so far, but theory kind of gets you to the door, you know. Yeah. And then it's up to you to like really just interpret what you're feeling and put it down. Like, of course you need progression. You need a chord progression, like, you know, chord progression podcast and that.
He said it. He said it.
Who, me? No. So I feel like the core of a song is the chorus, you know? If there is a chorus or if there's like a repeating section in a song, that's the bread and butter there. And then everything else is like complementary to it, to the song. And, you know, what makes a song to me more memorable is like the chord progression, the progression of whatever key we're in. But it's like creating your own storm in a musical term, you know? And yeah, like you said, it can only get you so far. But it's a good thing.
It is a good thing. I think you put it best with what's like, you know, it gets you to the door, but it's not going to get you through the door. It's your ideas and your vision and your creativity is going to be the thing that pushes you through that door. And beyond that, too, when you're talking about, you know, the chorus being that piece that really is connective overall. I mean, it doesn't always have to be the chorus, but typically it usually is. And when you think about some of those, you know, the songs that you absolutely love or the songs that have become some of the most famous, when you think about the lyrics, the way they're sung and the way they're put together, when you even sing them out loud or you just repeat them in your head, like you're singing along with it. But then in your head, too, you remember the progression and how that all works out because it's an earworm piece that really gets sunk into you and you follow along with it overall. So when you think about a song, like I'm just thinking about this, like Enter Sandman, like you can think of the intro and it's all going to fit together. And then when you think of the chorus, like you're kind of going along with the overall beat, with the overall rhythm, with that progression, and it's sunk in your head. And that's where the earworm comes in. And that's where that hook comes in to where when people think about the song, that's what they remember. That's what they're really connected to. That's where the base of where that connection comes from and all the complementary pieces add to it, but also expand on the story or the core of that story where that chorus is really coming from.
Absolutely. Yep. It's all about story, honestly.
Oh, yeah. And kind of coming off of that, too, I think it's kind of cool, like, at least for, like, our songwriting process, that was a little bit different for me that I think highlights some of that, is, like, writing a lot of our riffs, and particularly stuff that has clean vocals on it, we'll start with the top line, actually, and we'll kind of, like, figure out the top line and, like, build a riff underneath of that that helps support that, which for me was a little different. Like, I was used to just, like, let's make some crazy riff, but this is like, you know, let's start with the top line and like, how do we help that shine? You know,
absolutely.
And like, it's a little bit like give and take too. Cause like some of the heavy stuff, like you might start with the riff first because like you just want it to be nuts at that section or something.
Yeah.
But yeah.
You're like, look at this 20 hertz riff that I wrote. It's
Yeah.
like, whoa,
You're like,
what?
what? It's either that or it's like, you know, like we make like the worst noise you've ever heard on a guitar, and we're just like, do it again.
Yes.
Like, then we'll put it in a riff.
It's like, is that a triad? We're like,
I
fuck, I don't know.
don't
It
know.
sounds
It
good
sounded cool.
though.
It's like you're trying to kill the guitar. It sounds like you're choking, just going, ar. You're
Yeah.
like, wait a minute, we can turn that into a song and then knock Loose Mix Counting Worms off of
Oh,
it. And it
yeah.
did, you
Yep.
know? But it's different
Yeah.
when, especially for the music of gore, with what you guys are going for, especially when you get to those chorus pieces, because a lot of times those chorus pieces are really going to be those emotional connective things that are going to make you get as emotional as possible, that are going to make you want to cry in the pit. So when you start with the top line to really have more of that expanded nature to the sound, you can't really just have a heavy riff and try and make the craziest riff off of it underneath, because even with the top line going very open and with vocals from Haley maybe being more melodic, maybe angelic, maybe a little more powerful and theme to really put the point across. If you got a crazy riff under it, now you've got a huge mismatch of sound where I'm gonna be looking
Yeah.
at like, okay, am I listening to a Jackson Pollock painting, you know, in format? Like,
Yeah.
I really don't know. So it's that writing process that, of course, every band's gonna have a different writing process, because it's gonna all depend upon the music that you make and how you make it in the most optimal way to really bring out every single bit of emotion from the theme, from the lyrics, how that comes out in the vocal tone, in the vocal patterns, in the progressions, in the backing, in the riffs, in that top line, from the 20 megahertz bass riffs, and from the drumming pattern as well. There's so much that goes into it. But if you know exactly where you need to start to build the song and then go from there, like start with the top line and then going down, again, it makes sense because it hits for what you're trying to go for.
Exactly. Yeah. Like I said earlier, it's like creating your perfect storm. No pun intended here in Houston, but I'm just full of puns today, guys. I don't know what's going on. I think I drank some pun juice or something. Oh.
I mean, Alex,
But
you're turning this into pandemonium here.
it's absolute pun anarchy.
On the Punkcast right here.
Yeah, on the Chord Progression Podcast. I might have to change the name of the podcast when this episode comes out to the Chord Progression Puncast, and the episode is going to be Gore, just puns, only
Yeah, just puns.
puns.
Only puns.
Yeah.
Only puns. Only puns. Check out our only. I don't
Yeah.
even. I'll say there's three guys here. Just check out our OnlyMans account. Just
Yeah, only me.
that's it.
three guitars. No, wait.
Yep.
Oh, hold on.
Two
Three dudes, one
guitars and
guitar.
two
Yeah.
guitars and someone who's just happy to be here.
Yeah.
Yeah,
Oh my
dude.
God, yeah. We could possibly do something like that. Now I'm also half expecting you guys to write a song that's just gonna be full of puns on every line. I'm not sure Haley would necessarily go for it, but you never know. Call it pundemonium or puntastic puns and
Yeah.
honestly, Haley is one of the punniest people we know.
Oh,
Honestly.
really? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. She loves her puns, let's just say.
I was gonna say, is she a puncess, like a princess? But that doesn't really sound as good as it could. Nah.
It was almost there.
It's there.
I give it like a 6.5, not 7.
Dude, you don't have to be
Solid
that
seven.
generous. That was pretty bad. That was like a 3 on a good day.
I don't know. I'm just being, I mean.
It's like a strong 3 on the Anthony Fantano scale, right?
It's a very strong 3, but still can't beat out the weakest 4.
Yeah.
Mind
Man,
blown.
I gotta up. So if you know, by the chance I get, but when the time comes when I get to see Gore play live, I gotta up my pun game, because what am I gonna do if I have to rely on just the old ones that I still know and sit with? I mean, I can't just keep using pundemonium like crazy or chord progression pun cast now. Like, I have to think of some better stuff.
If you have any dad puns, I mean, those go a long
Oh.
way, honestly.
So I just have to. So if okay, I know exactly what I have to do then, and you guys are gonna get ready for this. So when I see you guys from live for the first time, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try and memorize as many jokes I can from the dad jokes subreddit, and just start spitting them
Oh,
out
yeah.
every chance I get, and we'll see not only how good I can do, but how long, you know, we can last before we're like, okay, this is ridiculous, and then just keep going and see how far we can go beyond that even.
I
I'm
wanna
all
hear that.
about
I
it.
wanna see it. Yeah.
Well, that one, especially if Haley's gonna be the punniest, I mean, what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to go to that subreddit and just go nuts with it, and you never know, you might find something that's absolutely crazy.
You never know. She might already have some locked in the chamber, and I'm just saying.
Oh yeah.
You gotta just write them down, you know, just write them down in your arm so you can always reference. I'm just like, let's see
Yeah.
what we got here. I'm actually
Peppering
gonna
your
get it
notes.
tattooed right here, dude. I'm gonna have it tattooed. All the puns. Oh, dude, that's a great tattoo idea. Maybe. I
Maybe.
don't know.
I'm
Well,
for it. Then what happens is you get older. It's like, well, I forgot what these pu I forgot the puns. I can't remember them. Then you just look at your arm, you're like, oh.
You're like, oh,
Yeah.
yeah.
It's like, are those words from, is those words from a family or an important text that or important book? Nope, it's just puns. Why?
Just puns.
Yeah. Why
The
not?
book of puns. Like the book of Eli, but with
Puns.
puns.
Or like I said, the Book of Poor Mormon, the book of more puns.
The Book of More Puns. I get it. That was a
I
good
mean,
one.
it could definitely fit if you want to use that one. I think that would be like, you know, I'd say a solid 6.1 maybe.
It is 6.9.
Okay, I'll take it. One
That's,
thing,
yeah, I'll
I
take
also
it.
do want to dive a little bit deeper into A Bud That Never Blooms because I want to make sure as many people get to know about this EP, get interested in this EP. So when it drops, they're like, oh my dear Lord, I have to go and check this out. I have to pre-save this right now. And when it comes out, I have to sit in my car and turn it all the way up to 11. Yes, I said 11. If your car goes beyond 11, keep going. Just keep going.
Yeah.
And
Rookie
jam
numbers.
out to it. Yeah, Brookie numbers. We gotta, those are Rookie numbers, man. We gotta up those. But when it came to a blue a Bud That Never Blooms, what was the overall inspiration behind this EP and how did you create this?
Well, Devin, I feel like Devin would answer that a lot more articulate than I can.
Oh man. I mean, it's kind of just builds on what we've already been talking about, just making this emotive just piece that just, you know, anger, sadness, anything we want to bring it in there. Like the whole theme of this EP and really the band, because like the EP is there to showcase, like, hey, here's this band, this is what we're about. And so, yeah, we really want to bring forth, like, so the concept of gore really is like, it's not like crazy terrifier gore, like blood and guts kind of thing. So, gore for this band in this context is emotional gore. And I think that's really what we're setting forward to, like, bring that to the table with this EP.
Yeah, it. I guess the best way you can we I personally would consider it is like it's like a concept album, but with emotion. Like the emotion is the one singular thing that's very common in every single one of our songs is the emotional, you know, the emotional aspect, but also the emotional story within each song. Because like it may not be a concept in the terms of like a story. Because each one of our songs is just a different story, but going through the traumas and the betrayals and all that, all the emotions that you receive or that you feel during those moments in time, just translating into each song. And because of that, each one of our songs, especially for this EP, is not like the previous one. Like the previous track, it's always you get a little bit of something different in every single track, and I think that's something that most people could expect when they listen to it. And honestly, I'm kind of excited for people to hear that because they're gonna be like, whoa, 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 this is a gore song, and we're like,
Yeah.
yes, it
Like
is.
every song's a curveball. Well,
Yeah, for real, yeah.
I can agree. I mean, the songs that are out there right now as singles, every one of those songs is a curveball in terms of sound because you've got Pray, which especially has a more aggressive backing, then the chorus has a little more of this openness to it. Where for Babylon, that chorus really opens up, I think, a little bit more. But on Pray, you know, the pre-chorus opens up to a vast array to really take you in. And then Doomsday sounds nothing like the other two. It's got a completely different overall feel. But I think you really hit the nail on the head when you said, we're not taking gore from, you know, the blood and guts gore that you see in every slasher movie and every horror movie. You have to take that idea of blood, guts, slashing, and destroying. but to your own inner emotions versus, you know, your actual fleshy self. So it's kicking your own emotions ass and trying to rip them apart through song. But it's going to take a different emotion and different idea, a different concept, a different feeling, a different moment in time on each and every one of these songs for you to really understand where the emotion is coming from, to where you're going to have to really dive deep and to think about certain things to really understand where you sit in with those moments, with those realizations, and with those emotions to really get further in there. Again, while crying in the pit and swinging your ass off because this is what's going to happen.
Absolutely.
You're going to get the heaviness. You're going to get the expansive parts of the chorus and the pre-chorus that really open it up. And a lot of the help is not only from the instrumental side to really be able to change on a dime, but you also have Haley's voice too, which can change on a dime as well to really drive that quick change for emotion and really take you into a vaster, more open space at times. In like a warp instead of just, you know, we have to slowly progress through the story. It's sometimes we can warp back to this one place emotionally because the ability is there from the progression and from the vocal change as well.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's the best way we can put it as far as like what to expect and you know the thought process and the ideas of what our EP is going to be like.
Yeah.
Yeah, again, you're gonna cry and you're gonna swing at the same time. Like
I'm getting emotional just thinking about
Yeah.
it right now, guys. So you see me crying or see a tear, if you can auto generate like a tear coming down, that'd be
Yeah.
great. Just a tear coming down here, and yeah, it's so emotional.
I might just have to add in just like throughout the rest of the episode now, just you just constantly having a tear
Yeah.
from one eye.
Sad boy
Dude,
hours.
I mean we a bunch of sad boys. What
If
can
we're
I
gonna meet
say?
some sad boys in here, then we can just, you know, maybe cut this one short. I can start playing some Mayday Parade for us. We can just all get in the feels.
If you do that, I'm gonna need to get a bottle of Jack.
All
Or
right,
some Johnny Walker.
we'll start playing some like Mayday Parade, Simple Plan. I'm trying to think,
Ooh.
who else could I throw in there? Just like
Some
getting
Pierce the
emotional.
Veil.
Some Pierce the Veil, yeah.
The Veil.
Story of the Year.
Photograph by Nickelback.
Yeah, absolutely. Just because you said Nickelback, I went to go see them at the rodeo here in Houston, and oh my God, that was like one of the
Oh.
best shows I've ever seen. I'm gonna be honest with you. I know a lot of people have a lot of Nickelback hate. I'm like, dude, I don't see what the big problem is, that these dudes are freaking killing it.
Oh, I've already told my friends the next time Nickelback comes around, we're just gonna go get drunk and go to the show because we're not gonna necessarily be able to mosh at the show, but why don't we just get super emotional to photograph?
Yeah.
Absolutely, dude. Oh man, so
100%.
good.
I mean, who knows? All of a sudden they might do Nickelback the Emotions Tour with Gore opening. It could happen.
Yeah. I think
Dude,
I cried.
I don't even know what I'm like, what am I doing here? Like
Yeah.
is this life?
Do I
Like,
go here? Like,
yeah. Do I play guitar?
they'll be playing Photograph, and both you'll be on the side stage like Ricky Bobby crying and be like,
Yeah.
I don't know what to do with my
My
hands.
hands.
Oh man, that's gonna be awesome.
It would be, and I would love to see it happen. But so this is one question I always like to ask, and especially with new music coming out too, because it's not going to be the easiest question to answer. But I'm always curious to hear what, you know, your answers are going to be. So, on A Bud That Never Blooms, the EP, there's five songs on there. We've heard three of them. We have not heard two of them. Now, normally I ask this in a different way because I have a lot more unreleased tracks to work with, but I'm going to ask you in a different way. Out of these five songs, which one is the one that you would say is your, now I'm not going to say favorite, but the one that you most want people to listen to if they have not checked out Gore yet? It can be one of the unreleased ones too, so we can anticipate that even more. Up to you, but I want to know which one are you most excited for fans to hear or for people to hear for the first time?
That's so it's
Ooh, this
such a
is
loaded
hard.
question.
They're
That's
all
a
so
such a
different.
Yeah, because it's like I could ask you what your favorite
Man.
is, but it's like you created these songs. It's like picking one of your favorite children. But if I'm like, is there one that just like I can't wait for the fans to hear this one? I can't wait for what the reaction's gonna be, or for new fans, I can't, this is the one I would suggest for them to check out first. Like, I gotta make it a little different, and I can't make it too easy on you.
Okay, well, I don't know, Devin. Do you want to take this one? You
Man,
want
it's so hard to just pick
to...
one of them.
Okay, so I'm gonna be. It's one of the unreleased songs that I really want everybody to listen to. It's "Heaven Is Above Me" is the name of the track. That one for me is it's very, you know, theme of the whole podcast and the theme of the whole song of the whole band is it's very emotional. It's very raw in the way that you feel listening to the song, and it's very angelic, but kicks you in the penis. So just so you know, it's a great song.
An emotional song that's gonna kick you right in the manhood.
Yep, absolutely.
Yeah, I might have to agree with that one. 'Cause like I feel like Prey could work. I feel like sonically, Prey is a very good introduction to the band and like what we're about, what we can do. And Heaven Is Above Me just goes deep into that emotional part. It's like at least like, you know, when I've like showed my brother or something when we got all these done, that has been the song that people have been like, holy crap, you know?
It's quite a journey. The song is quite a journey. It's not your like typical like, oh, cool. You know, that's a great song. It's more like, oh man, you gotta listen to this. Like you have to like really just sit and just listen to the lyrics, take it all in, and you're just like, wow, that's a great song.
I think that was one of the ones that, like, especially when we got like the final master back, I was just like, holy crap. I was like, this is insane.
Oh yeah. Cody mixed the hell out of that sucker.
Oh yeah,
See now
he
how you're
crushed.
I'll say now how you're describing it is like I'm not expecting to be like, okay, you know, you listen, you're like, damn, that was a good song. I'm gonna put that on my playlist. What I'm expecting is to be driving in my car once again and listen to the song, and then by the time it's over, I'm just sitting there stoned, grabbing on the wheel, like, what did I just experience? What did I
Absolutely.
just feel? Because I have had songs do that before, so I want my above my head by Polaris moment with this song where I'm like,
Oh.
what the fuck did I just deal with?
Yeah.
I have to go
Yep.
through this again to really see, did I just feel all that? And then like, yep. And now mentally, I am not gonna be the same for the rest of the evening.
Yeah, exactly.
Although,
It's such a good track. Sorry, I didn't mean to cut
yeah, it's like all those emotions you try to shove away, we're gonna bring them right back out.
you. Thought you repressed that emotion? Well, think again. It's like
Think again,
The one where you
bucko.
bottled, it's like when you bottle up all those emotions and the final moment happens where just, you know, you can't pop anymore, the bottle breaks and all the emotions come out. It's like that's what's gonna happen with this song, but it's gonna be in a constructive manner for you.
Absolutely.
Constructive release.
You're gonna be your inner child is gonna do that thing that kids do when they're about to cry and they're about to cry,
They're
but
like,
there's no
hey.
sound. There's no sound before they're about to like Yeah, that's exactly what it is going
That's what
to
it's gonna be. Alrighty. I'm glad you guys picked one of the unreleased ones though, because I can say it this way. For my opinion, when it comes to the band, if especially for you, if you want a track to start out with, especially for the ones that are out released right now, if you want one that's gonna show the potential of what is going to come from Gore and what can possibly still be done and where the sound can go, Prey is gonna be the one that you want to take on. If you want to get the most emotional to start out with and really get more of that angelic, really hits you in the feels drive, that's where you're gonna go to Doomsday. If you like the heavier stuff, if you like more of the alt metal side of things, if you really want to go with something that's gonna really drive you home and more of that consistent heavier feel, that's where Babylon's gonna come in. So I still suggest listening to all three, but if you have a feeling of I want to see where this band's coming from, I want to know what's going to be a little more safe for the heavy side of things, or I want to go with what's going to emotionally try and wreck me, you have your options right there. But you
Absolutely.
want to do that so then you're ready for the EP to come out so you can listen to Angels Like You, then prepare for Heaven Is Above Me and have that moment where you're stoned in the car, not stoned, but like in the car, like, what just happened, and then have that moment where you're about to have your inner child cry out, but it just is about to burst, but it can't. So it's gonna be like,
that is the move.
That's the move. That's Gore's mission.
I feel like if I had the size of a podcast like Joe Rogan, someone would just clip that, and that'd have been like the next meme for October.
Oh yeah,
they would have just been like when he starts listening to Deftones.
Yeah,
you know, not wrong. I'll say for me, it's when New Rise Against music gets announced.
He's like.
Like he's trying to contain his excitement, but something clearly is happening there. That man is feeling something.
He's going through it.
We always joke in the band. It's like, man, that sounds horny. Release it. That's what Deftones does.
Yeah.
Deftones is like, man, that sounds sexy.
Hey, if it's sexy, it sounds horny. That's what number bands do. I mean, they didn't call it I know they called it baddie core, but like I called it horny core for another reason. It's like, you know, bands like, you know, sometimes Spirit Box can be putting their Bad Omens from Death of Peace of Mind, Sleep Token. Mm-hmm. You throw bands like, or Catch Your Breath, throw bands like there. It's like, oh no, that's going to get you in the feels, but in the
good. Oh yeah.
It's horny core, baby.
Yeah.
Horny core. Yeah. Catch Your Breath, such a good band.
Oh yeah. Love those guys. I have them up on the board here because they're coming on the podcast very, very
soon. Oh, awesome.
The third time.
Nice. Oh, man, that's so awesome. Yeah, my old band played with them before they went on the Falling in Reverse tour.
Okay.
Here in Houston, because I think they're out of Austin.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, like, my old groups have, like, we don't know each other. Only talked to them a few times, but they're such nice guys, honestly.
Yeah, I always like talking with them. It's always a good time, and I'm like, I can't wait to talk to them again, but also, you know, see them on tour again, and just like, oh, this is gonna be great, and just keep seeing them grow and thrive. It's always a good thing. Plus, then, you know, we'll add a little bit more of that, you know, the feels to it, because
the feels,
they
get
the feels too, for sure.
Yeah, they're a great band, honestly. So happy for them.
Yeah, man. They're going to hit you right in the chest, and the little kid's going to go, I like this.
The freaking lip movement.
Yeah.
Oh, God. All righty. Well, a couple other questions. Another one is, so when the EP releases, I know you're also going out Within the Ruins to support some of the stuff in October 2024. Beyond that, what's the future look like for Gore? What else you got coming our way?
Man, well, working on new music. Trying to see, we want to play more shows, but we're still trying to see what that's going to look like. Beyond that, couldn't really tell you.
Open book.
Yeah.
Beyond that, the world is your oyster. You just have to figure out where that oyster is and how to get it.
Absolutely.
Yep.
But that's the beauty of it. It's you're gonna have the shows within the ruins, then you're gonna release the EP, and you're gonna see where it's gonna go from there. And I also like the fact that you're like, well, we'll see where it goes. It's you're not like trying to force an expectation on there, so you're able to let these things happen and enjoy the process as it comes, because it's not every day someone releases a brand new EP or debut EP. It's not every day where someone is in a, where any musician is in a band where it's like, this could viably easily be something. It's not every day that happens. So I'm just saying, enjoy it and make the most of it and enjoy the ride.
Yeah. Thanks, man. Honestly, we're just happy to be here.
Yeah,
we're just happy that people like listening to us.
Yeah. I mean, like, if people liked it or not, like, I love doing this stuff with these guys. Yeah. But it's really cool, like, where it's taken us so far. So, just going to keep riding the wave.
Then for one of the shows, can you guys come out in t-shirts that says, I'm just happy to be here?
Yeah.
Well, like, Comic Sans font, just, like, right there.
Yes, actually Comic Sans font, or
it has to be.
Font. Big metalcore band in impact letters.
Yeah.
Something like that. Well, guys, I got one more question before we wrap this up. Are you ready for it?
Let's hear it.
Something I like to ask every single artist I bring in the podcast, been doing this for over a year because it helps us as music fans to get to know more about the new music that's out there that we might not know about, but for you guys to also tell us about the music that you absolutely love. So between the two of you, can you guys give me three bands or artists that you love that you would like to see more people get into right now?
Ooh. Oh, man. Is this like new or just anyone we can think of?
Anyone, but if there's someone where it's like, I'd love to see more people get into these guys or these into these girls or into this artist, that's where I really like to go for. I'd love to shine light on people that you guys feel deserve to see get more recognition in this music world.
I gotta think for a sec.
I got like two bands that I'm thinking of right now. One of them's already in the industry, and it's one of Devin's favorites, and it's one of my favorites recently, is the Bill Murray, or just Bill Murray.
Bill Murray. Yeah, okay.
Bill Murray rocks.
Bill Murray's so good, dude. I went to go see them last Thursday, and that was like the best show ever. So good. And the other one is, for me, is probably my old band, Stoneside. They're really, really great dudes, and love the music, but yeah. Gore took up most of my time, so all of my time.
You wanted to get violent emotionally.
Yeah. I wanted to get emotionally just belligerent.
Just punching you right in the feels.
Yeah.
I guess for a third one, this might be a little bit of curveball, definitely outside of her genre, but I'm going to go with Ethel Kane. It's kind of recency bias, but I've recently gotten into her. It's like indie kind of stuff, but it's just super emotional. Like her 2022 album, like, I don't think I've ever had that sort of emotional experience. It's like I sat through a horror movie or something, but it was very beautiful music, though. She's incredible.
See, that's the kind of stuff we love, because it's just like, of course, I mean, more people know Bill Murray. Alex, you get to support your buddies as well. And then Devin, you get to throw us something that, you know, might not necessarily fit within the rock and metal genre, but something that a lot of people should check out as well. Hell, I mean, I've had people throw me synthwave bands on here because they're like, you got to go check this out. I'm like, hell yeah, give me some of that. So I'm always down for whatever, and I'm always glad to hear what you guys are listening to see where we can support that. And I want to thank you guys for taking the time today. I really appreciate it. I want to close out this podcast with three specific things. Okay, first things first. When it comes to gore, when it comes to these fantastic gentlemen right here who are going to help you get violent with your own emotions, gore style, best thing you can do to not only be ready for that and to check out what they got going on in the future, but to also make sure you're ready when the EP Above the Never Blooms drops on October 24th, is go to the description of the podcast where it says Find Gore Online. Links, labels for everything, social media, YouTube, website, merch, where you can pre-save the album or the EP, where you can stream it when it's out, and you can go get tickets to go see them live, are all going to be down there. So I'm doing all the work for you. I'm doing all the research. Call me Kevin the Googler, and all you have to do is click and you're good to go, or tap, whatever you want to do. If you're on your phone, go tappy, tappy, tap. So I got you covered. Now it's time for number two. Gentlemen, this is something I intend to do as a promise to bands and artists I enjoy the podcast. It's a way for me to say thank you for being on the podcast, and I wish you continue to support the band in the future. So this is promise starts with when. That implies we're going to do this, day or time yet to be determined. But when I get to see you perform live for the first time, I will look for you. I will find you. I will probably yell at you for making me cry and swing at people in the pit. But the real promise is this, gentlemen. First round's on me.
Oh, thanks, man.
My guy. Thank you.
And also, if you see me in the crowd and all of a sudden it's like, oh, I know that guy. Literally, you might be called, hey, we see some guy in the crowd that we know. He interviewed us. He promised us the first round. Kevin, we're going to be at this spot right after the show.
Yeah.
And yeah, absolutely. At that point, I might just be like, flip you off, run to the bar, get it, and be like, here you guys go, right on stage. Yeah. No, not here.
You're going to watch me. If you give me a shot, you're probably going to see me just like, how do I play guitar again?
Yeah.
It's like, well, what kind of shot was this? It's Capri Sun, motherfucker.
Oh, even better.
Yeah. You know what? I'm not even going to be mad about that. In fact, I might.
Honestly, honestly, there's some Capri Sun in my Capri Sun in my fridge, right? Devin, there's going to be Capri Sun when you get here, dude.
There's not going to be anyone I leave there.
You know what? Scratch that. Instead
You're
of fucking
absolutely
about me, what
right.
if I just bring a couple of boxes of Capri Sun to the show and be like,
Yeah,
"This
I'm
is
sold.
You just gotta throw one at me. I'm just gonna be like, hurry up
Gonna
before
throw
my.
just one at you. I'm just gonna throw either the box at you, or I'm just gonna start going like this. I'm gonna make it rain
Yeah.
complete sun on you, baby.
I'll crush it on stage and throw it in the pit. Like...
Yeah,
Okay, that's a great idea. We're making this happen. Guys, now it's time for number three. I can end this episode by saying goodbye. This is a hell of a lot of fun. Making good on that promise, either first round or bringing a bunch of Capri Sun to a show, because I think that's funny as hell. But I'd love to be back again on the podcast in the future and bringing Haley on as well. So, guys, this cannot be goodbye. This is, I'll see you later.
See you later,
See
man.
you later.
Well, folks, this is my interview with Alex and Devin from the band Gore. Now it's time for Kevin's final thought. And when they describe their music as emotional and heavy hitting, and they're going to say, you're going to be crying in the middle of the pit and swinging, I absolutely loved it. And the main thing I really remember was, when we talked about the EP, A Bud That Never Blooms. This is what I love about bands like this, especially when they release debut EPs, because the songs they release, they show so much range and you don't even know what's to come next. Take a look at a song like Pray. Pray really shows that emotional depth the band can go into with how heavy they're able to go as well, and really transition it and understand the way that those transitions work and how kind of throw, using music theory to get you to the door, but then throwing it out the window and going after what you want to push yourself through the door was absolutely the right move. Doomsday takes it in a completely different light with a much softer sound, a much more, I'm not gonna say anthemic, but much more, ballad type style song that really gets you in the feels. Babylon is more of the song that you're really gonna want to hit on and just really find more of that consistent metal sound to it. But when they were talking about Heaven Is Above Me, like, that got me so excited to listen to this song. I am ready for it. I want to listen to this song. I want to hear it now. I want to be in my car getting in the feels of it. And I want to see this band succeed because they have something that not many bands do, where they have a drive, a consistency, and a creativity to put all these things together. And they have an idea of how they're going to do it. I mean, Revolver Magazine listed them this year as one of the five badass bands you need to know. And they involve bands like Chained Saint, who've been on the podcast, Silly Goose, who you all know, who tried to get on the podcast, but we're still working on that, Deadlands, who you know, and once they release their debut album, they'll be on the podcast, and Alt. So they're on a good list with that one, so be sure to check them out. When it comes to finding Gore online, go straight to the podcast. Links, labels for everything for them are below. Be sure to also follow along with us on the Corporate Rush Podcast. Links for Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram are in the podcast description. Be sure to subscribe to us on YouTube. Follow us on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. Like this episode, I'll push in the algorithm. I want to thank everybody for listening. Thank you to Alex and Devin for being on the podcast. It's a pleasure, guys. And I'll see you next time with Capri Sun. On that note, that's gonna be it for me today, everybody. Thank you for watching the Chord Progression Podcast. My name is Kevin, and you guys know how I end every single one's episodes. Big, healthy, and hearty. See y'all.
Yeah.